Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpying. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's check the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And we see that the market has recorded a slight price change for the last 24 hours. And in this way, I would say that the major cryptocurrencies, they continue to move sideways or to consolidate. But of course, cryptocurrency users, they are really very big, most of them, I mean, very big optimists in the long run, and they believe in the bright future of the cryptocurrency world. And of course, there are many factors that they think will support in the long run the cryptocurrency market. And that's why today I want to mention some of such kind of positive statements relating to the cryptocurrency world and some factor behind these positive statements. And let me start with some tweets about the extremely loose monetary policy conducted by the central banks, in particular by the Federal Reserve of the United States. So Bloomberg says breaking. Jerome Powell, the chairman of the Fed Reserve, says that Fed will seek inflation that averages 2% over time. And according to experts, it means that they will try to increase the level, the current level of inflation, and in the long run, that will affect negatively the purchasing power of the US dollar, and it will, of course, affect positively the prices of many assets and hedges against inflation, including cryptocurrencies and bitcoins. That's why Tyler Winklevoss said that the Fed, under the leadership of Jerome Powell, continues to be Bitcoin biggest booster. On Thursday, he will deliver a speech about how the Fed will begin targeting higher inflation. And for example, even Brad Gerlinghaus, the CEO of Ripple, also mentioned and commented on this extremely loose monetary policy conducted by the Fed Reserve. And he said that in the face of the case of precedent, science point to further dollar debasement in the near term, leading to further diversification of assets, which will certainly be good for crypto. And this is all about the extremely loose monetary policy conducted by the central banks, in particular in the United States. And that's why I decided to check the current level of the inflation rate in the United States. And according to recently published statistics, the consumer price index on a monthly basis has increased in recently by 0.6%. During the previous month, the month-on-month increase was also 0.6%, and those two levels are one of the highest ones for the last, let's say, 5 or even 10 years. So this is extremely high monthly levels, indicating a significant increase of inflation. But if we check the data about the how the inflation look on a yearly basis, we see that it is still relatively low. It is still below the target of 2%. So the unadjusted 12 months ended July 2020 level is just 1%. It used to be 0.6%, 0.6%. So this is relatively low level according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics in the United States. But anyway, I'm pretty sure that if the central banks, or at least in my view, I think that in the long run, if the central banks continue to conduct this extremely loose monetary policy, to conduct this quantitative easing by which they inject a lot of liquidity into the global financial system, it will affect positively many financial assets, including the cryptocurrencies as well. And this is a positive factor, of course, for the prices of the cryptocurrencies. But of course, I would like to mention also some other interesting factors and positive, let's say, news about the cryptocurrency market. And I would like to mention an article on CoinDesk that was exclusive for CoinDesk article, in which there is information that the number of total bitcoins in miner wallets is at a local high. So this is a very high level. And according to some experts, it means that miners, they expect higher levels, and that's why they don't sell their bitcoins at the moment. They wait for better times. And of course, this is something positive for the cryptocurrency market, I mean for Bitcoin as well, because the supply is, let's say, limited in this way. And of course, if many miners think that the price will go up, probably it will definitely go up sooner or later, because they're very well informed with the ecosystem of Bitcoin. So that's why, for example, miners holdings data appears to be a bullish signal, according to Thomas Heller, former director at leading mining pool F2Pool, who discussed it with CoinDesk in a private message. So many people think that this is a very positive signal for the price of Bitcoin. And that's it about Bitcoin, and I want to mention some final news relating to digital currencies, because many people started to comment on a recent post or actually tweet about the development of the digital currencies in China. We know that China is a huge market. And China Construction Bank, one of the leading banks in China, has opened digital Yuan wallet registration, and user can now apply for digital renminbi wallet by searching for digital currency on CC on China Construction Bank app. The wallet currently supports bank card recharge, QR code collection and payment, as well as transfer. And of course, I checked some similar articles and tweets about this announcement, about the, let's say, launch of this application by which people can take advantage of this digital yuan, Chinese currency. Some people think that this is positive for the cryptocurrency market, others think that it is not that positive. They just claim that this is a centralized currency, it doesn't matter that it's digital, it's not a cryptocurrency. But anyway, I think that this is something nice. First of all, it is just a sign about the development of the digital technologies all over the world. Also, in addition, I think it is a free marketing for the cryptocurrency world, because still there are many people that are skeptic about the cryptocurrencies, but when they hear that some leading central banks or some leading private banks are going to support digital currencies, they associated with cryptocurrencies, and they start to change their mind or their negative views about the cryptocurrencies, and they become, let's say, a little bit more open to new technologies and to cryptocurrencies as well. That's why I think that this is a positive free marketing for the cryptocurrency world. And of course, it's a kind of a bridge that will bring new people into these digital currencies, and at the end of the day, will bring many of them into the cryptocurrency world as well. So that's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. I wish you a wonderful Sunday and hope to see you in the next one. It was me at CryptoSpark.